So next we are going to see physiological changes. So in physiological changes, first we are going to see reproductive system, okay? So in reproductive system, first vagina, okay? In vagina, there may be hypertrophy and hyperplasia, okay? Hypertrophy and hyperplasia, okay? And edematous. Vagina will be edematous, okay? And next one is vaginal wall, okay? Vaginal wall will be increased. And increased vascular, okay? Increased in vascular. And here a Jacmel sign will be present, okay? It is a Viva question. Jacmel sign means bluish discoloration of the vagina, okay? Bluish discoloration of vagina. It occurs due to lack of fluid, okay? Due to lack of fluid, Jacmel sign will be present, which means a bluish discoloration, okay, of the vagina. And next one is uterus, okay? In uterus, increase in shape and size, okay? There may be an increase in shape and size, okay? And in uterus, stretching present. And due to stretching, it leads to linea niagara, okay? Linea niagara and stria gravida, okay? Linea niagara means it is a straight line, okay, which can be seen in the mother's stomach. And stria gravida is a silvery line, okay? And next one is shape, okay? Oval in shape or round, okay? And uterus weighs about 1 kg, okay? And it gradually increases up to 35 centimeter, okay? And here hypertrophy and hyperplasia will be there, okay? Hypertrophy and hyperplasia is common for all the system, okay? So in 12th week, it looks like a grapefruit, okay? And in 16th week, it looks like globular shape, okay? And in 20th week, spherical in shape. And 30th week, lower uterine segment can be identified, okay? In 13th week, lower uterine segment can be identified, okay? And the fundus is palpated, okay? In 13th week, the fundus is palpated between the midway of the umbilicus and xiphoid sternum, okay? So, this is all about in a uterus. And next one is lightening, okay? In uterus, lightening. So, lightening means it is a reduction, okay? So, we call it as a reduction. And here, weight increases, okay? Weight increases. And here, Braxton Hick will be present, okay? Braxton Hick means it usually occurs in third trimester, okay? In third trimester, Braxton Hick will be present, which means a false pain, okay? False pain or false uterine contraction, we called as Braxton Hick, okay? False pain or false uterine contraction, we called as Braxton Hick, okay? And next one is cervix, okay? Hope you all understand. If you have any doubts, please ask in comment section, okay? So, in cervix, hypertrophy and hyperplasia. Hypertrophy and hyperplasia is common for all system. You can add, okay? And edematous. So, in cervix, Godel sign will be present, okay? So, Godel sign means softening of the cervix, okay? Softening of cervix called Godel sign, okay? So, it occurs due to fluid accumulation in the tissue, okay? So, Godel sign occurs due to fluid accumulation in the tissue, okay? So, and vascularity increases, okay? So, vascularity increases due to the bluish discoloration, okay? And next one is fallopian tube. So in fallopian tube, it increases in length, okay? Increase in length. And hypertrophy and hyperplasia, already I said. Hypertrophy and hyperplasia, okay? So next one is ovary. Okay, in ovary, estrogen and progesterone level increases. Estrogen and progesterone level will be increases, okay? So it is secreted by corpus luteum, okay? For maintaining the environment of ovum, secreted by corpus luteum, okay? To maintain the environment of the ovum, okay? So in 8th week, there may be a bright orange. It looks like a bright orange, and then it turns to yellow, and yellow to pale white. Okay. So in ovary, estrogen and progesterone level increases. Okay, secreted by the corpus luteum to maintain the environment of the ovum. Okay, so in the 8th week, the ovary looks like bright orange and yellow, and it later it turns to pale white. Okay, so this all about in ovary. So next one in breast. Okay. So in breast, vascularity increases. Okay, increases hypertrophy and hyperplasia. Okay, HT means hypertrophy and hyperplasia. Okay, and tenderness will be there. Okay, due to enlargement of breast, tenderness will be present. Okay, stria gravidum will be present. And nipple and areola will be large, okay? Large, and nipple will be erected, okay? In nipple and areola, it is large and nipple will be erected, okay? And here montigmentary tubercles will be present. Montigmentary tubercles, which means it is an invisible sebaceous gland, okay? Invisible sebaceous gland to visible sebaceous gland, okay? So montigmentary tubercles means from invisible sebaceous gland to visible sebaceous gland, okay? So in 12th and 16th week, thick and yellow colostrum will be present, okay? Thick and yellow colostrum secreted, okay? When breast is palpated, thick and yellow colostrum will be secreted, okay? So next one is skin. So in skin, colasma will be present, okay? Colasma means, so these aren't all viva questions. So it is a butterfly mask, okay? Which means butterfly mask will be seen in the face, okay? In the skin, usually around the forehead cheek, okay, colasma will be present, and hirsutism also there. And hirsutism means fine hair on the skin, okay, fine hair on the skin. So in skin, colasma and hirsutism will be present, okay. So next one is metabolic changes, okay. In metabolic changes, first one is carbohydrate, okay? So in carbohydrate, transfer of increased amount of glucose from mother to fetus, okay? From mother to fetus, okay? In carbohydrates, glucose will be transferred in an increased amount from mother to fetus, okay? So next one is increased insulin, okay? Increased insulin secretion in response to glucose and amino acid, okay? Increased insulin secretion will be present because of in response to glucose and amino acid, okay? And next one is fat, okay? In fat, 3 to 4 kg of fat accumulated in the body of the mother, okay? 3 to 4 kg of fat is accumulated in body of the mother. Especially the fat will be accumulated on the thigh, abdomen wall and lips, okay? So next one is protein. So 500 grams of protein will be needed, okay? 500 grams. And next one is iron. So 1000 mg of iron is needed during pregnancy, okay? So the iron is needed for pregnancy in the form of ferrous and iron, okay, can be absorbed, and the iron can be absorbed mainly in the duodenum and jejunum, okay? So next one is HB drops leads to anemia. You all know that HB drops leads to anemia, okay? So next